to the tour bus at 5 o'clock. Or you checking out your hotel at 4:30. Maybe be checking out sometimes at 3:45 to go to the next city. And, you know, depending on where you go, some people took their tour bus cross country. So that's a 3-day drive. 2 days if you go straight, but that's pretty much a 3-day drive. So, you know, you really put your body to the test. Budweiser, everything was catered. So, God, I ate terrible. I gained like 10, 15 pounds. But eventually, like halfway through the tour, I just couldn't eat like that no more. It was good. It was so good. So good. But by the middle of the tour, I was blending fruits and making juices in the mornings and, you know, just having a light lunch and one big meal a day. So, you know, you kind of snap out of it after the first few cities. But it's a lot of fun though. Tour is cool. I have an album out. It's actually an EP, 831, Volume 1. What's That Sound? 8 letters, 3 words, and 1 meaning. I could leave you to think about what that means, but I'll just tell you, it means I love you. The album is more so about, you know, not just love between two people, but, you know, just the general love of living and all of the things that you go through just on a daily from living. As long as there's breath in your body, you always have to live. So you have to find a way to cope with that even when, you know, when you're not having a good day. So that's what that is. And right now I'm in the studio working on an EP that I'm gonna release in about 6 or 7 weeks. I'm gonna release it before the end of the year. It'll be 831 Volume 2. I haven't decided what I'm gonna title it yet. And I'll probably release 2 projects next year. I'll release a full-length album, probably this time next year. So I'm looking forward to doing that, and I'm releasing some things in the UK. So a lot of the internet stations, you may be able to pick up some new songs in the UK. My biggest markets are Japan and the UK. So I'll be releasing a lot of things there. So actually, when I put my first single out in 2008, and they were the first to buy it in bulk. So that was kind of amazing to me. I had a few songs that were leaked, and then when the project came out, they jumped right on it, and that's how I found out what my biggest markets were.
I'm a Christian. My faith is Christianity. Born again. I was baptized in a Baptist church. I moved around a lot when I was younger. Now I go to a non-denominational church, and you know, but the focus is still Jesus Christ. A lot of times, I like to, you know, like I said, going around and talking to different people. You know, a lot of times, they won't say anything at first, but then they'll just ask me, you know, what do you do? Because I'm really chill. Like, I believe that things are going to work out the way that they're supposed to. As long as you put in the work and, you know, you do what you have to do, you know, what you do is between you and God. Nobody knows your journey but you and God. And so, you know, I'm not the type of person to shove, you know, religion down anybody's throat or anything like that. A lot of times people will just see how you live and they'll want to know. You know, they'll kind of want to know, you know, well, you know, well, what is it? And I think it's been real cool that I've been able to tell people, you know, I'm a Christian. And they say, oh, okay, well, you don't quote scriptures or nothing like that. And I'm like, well, I know them, but why would I walk around, you know, quoting scriptures? It's cool to know them, and it's cool to be able to apply them, but at the same token, you have to be yourself. You don't have to be a certain way, you know, just because people are expecting you to be a certain way, because everybody's at a different point in their life. And you know, you can't expect, just because one person say that they're a Christian, you can't expect for them, you know, it's a process. It's an ongoing process. And you just can't expect for people to be perfect. And that's my whole thing, and, you know, going around and, you know, just talking to people. A lot of times, you know, people say things like, I want to get myself together before I go to church. And, you know, my reply to that is always, well, then you won't need to go to church because you can do it all by yourself. And so, you know, a lot of times I'm at home, a lot of my friends, they laugh because every Sunday I make sure I go to church. You know, every Sunday that I can, I make sure I go to church because it helps me stay, you know, kind of helps me stay grounded. And,
you know, just to be around like my church family, they don't care about none of that, none of the stuff that I'm doing. You know, it's, they just want to, you know, chill, and you know, we just want to be there for each other. And I'm happy that I go to one of those churches where you don't have to, you know, constantly be looking over your shoulder, you know, worry about people talking about you or anything like that. So it's really cool to just be on my journey and to understand that it is a journey, and I don't have to try too hard to do anything, because the things that I do is just between me, you know, between me and God. Nobody can judge me, you know, nobody can say anything to me that can make me feel any different about myself. But faith is cool. Faith has kept me in the game. Having faith and just knowing that it's that, just to have that hope, just hope is everything. When you don't have hope, you don't have anything. You know, when you have faith and you're willing to go out and act on that faith and work towards something, whether it be, I have faith that I'm going to get money. I have faith that I'm going to write 10 songs this week. I have faith that I'm going to tie my shoe before I walk. You know, whatever it is, you got to go out and you got to put forth that effort to do that. And as long as you do that, you know, you get out what you put in. Like, I still, when I grew up, you might still get hit by your next door neighbor. You know what I'm saying? And then when you get home, you might still get hit by your parents after you got hit by your next door neighbor. And, you know, now it's like people just like, oh, don't say nothing, that ain't my kid, as long as they not in my yard. And then, you know, then people just don't, you know, a lot of times people just don't care like they used to. But it's love is what we need. We just need to have more love. And, you know, a lot of people still do care. But I've seen people stick together. It took a village to raise me. I bounced, like, when I was younger, it was a lot of transitions, a whole lot of transitions. And, you know, it took a community. I can remember growing up and staying with my grandmother. She was on the first wave of women in law enforcement in D.C. And her and all of her, you know, her best friends, they were police. But they raised me. I can remember meeting Coretta Scott King when I was younger. And I was just with them. I would always, you know, they would always just have me around. And if I needed to be corrected, they would correct me. It didn't matter which one of them it was. And, you know, to this day, I can call them right now. They my aunts. It's like they blood. You know, I'm closer to some of them than I am with my own family. And, you know, so I just know that it takes a village. If you got people around you that really love you, that love will, it'll manifest itself inside of you and inside of your heart. And you'll be able to reciprocate that to everybody you meet, no matter, you know, how much wrong somebody might do to you. You'll still have the ability and the heart to still love, you know, to still love. Now, you're not going to be stupid, but on the same token, you know, you won't allow those things to take away from how you love and how you do the things that you do. I'm just happy to even have grown up the way that I wouldn't change a thing. I didn't meet my dad really until I was 20. And my stepfather, grew up with him between ages 3 and 10. A lot of different things that make up a person. And everybody's story is different. And you know, I believe that we go through the things that we go through so we can help somebody else. So what's the point of going through it if you ain't gonna help nobody? Somebody help me, and I feel like it's my duty in life to help other people as much as I can. So I guess that's what it is.
Hey, what's up, man?
Brother, what's up? It's
just a big party, man.
It's good to see you.
Stop it, right on.
Hey, man, what's your name?
Sweet day. Yes, Kyonte. What's up, man? How you doing, man?
Everything.
Get down today, boy.
Mother. Too many of you crying. Brother, 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 there's far too many of you dying. You know we've got to find a way to bring some loving here today. Oh, Father, Father, we don't need to. War is not the answer, for only love can conquer hate. bring some loving here today. Oh, picket lines, picket signs, punish me with brutality. Just talk to me.
It's my duty in life to help other people as much as I can.